the sound, vocabulary that astounds. From the planet lexicon, watch her villains, here she comes. Faced with a catastrophe, we need the living dictionary. Her superior intellect keeps the crime world in check. Oh girl, huggy faces by her side, vocabulary a mile wide. She'll make sure that crime will pay, then throw some mighty words your way. Word up, it's Word Girl.
Listen for the words faculty and expect.
It's another early morning. Excuse me. And Becky and Bob are getting a lift to school. They usually walk.
Becky, you're probably wondering why I'm driving you to school today.
Actually, I hadn't really...
I have a surprise! And I cannot tell you, okay? I'll tell you. Bum-ba-da-ba-bum-bum-bum! You're in the car with a new, official, substitute teacher from Miss Davis's class.
My teacher, Miss Davis?
Yep. She came down with a particularly pesky case of chicken pox. And after what I understood to be a very thorough 10-minute search, the principal gave me a call. Do you believe it, Becky? I'm a teacher.
So you're my new teacher?
Yes, I'm part of the faculty. Starting now! Becky, get to class. Kidding.
Yes, I see what you did there.
Wait, is that the time? Becky, get to class! And me too! Good morning, class! I am your substitute teacher, Mr. Botsford. Botsford. I'll write it on the board later. Pop quiz! Becky! Get it, Becky? I'm your pop, and I'm giving you a quiz? Pop quiz!
Yes, I get it.
Good one, Mr. Botsford.
Dad? Oh, I mean, Mr. Dadford? No. Mr. Bot's dad. I mean, Mr. Botsford!
Woo! Maybe you'll do better next time.
Oh.
Okay, and now let the learning begin. 10, 11. Ah, exercise. Pop quiz scoops.
Yes, Mr. Botsford?
Healthy bodies equal what?
Healthy minds?
Well done, scoops. A plus. Your reward? 5. More knee bends.
Your dad's hilarious. Don't you love having him as our teacher?
Yeah, well, I think he's doing okay.
Becky, let's cut down on the chatter, okay? I expect less talking and more knee bending. Hee-yah!
Oh. Hi, Hank. Want a little scratch? You like a little scratchy scratch?
Now, Becky, let someone else pet Hank. Don't go hogging the guinea pig.
Hog the guinea pig. Funny.
That was a pop quiz joke, Scoops. A+, great job.
Thanks, Mr. Botsford.
Hog the pig.
Seriously, though, Becky, don't hog the guinea pig. This hat is a clue. Quick, pop hat quiz. Where's Saskatchewan? Becky, I know you know this.
Yes, I know it. It's,
Too long. Scoops.
Canada.
Nice.
No.
Woo.
Well, Becky, you can expect to spend the weekend reviewing these flashcards. So long story short, a mystical elf in a flannel jumpsuit has nothing to do with why rhombuses have four sides of equal length. Kyle, I hope that answers your question. Oh, that's all the time we've got. Okay, goodbye, mathematicians. I'm so happy to be a new addition to your classroom.
Another winner, Mr. Botsford.
Okay.
Mr. Botsford?
You know what? Close enough.
Dad?
Not right now, Becky. I have a lot of work to do.
Right, but school's over, so are we leaving soon?
Oh, I expect to be here a while. So you and Bob should, just walk home.
Oh, well, okay. Bye.
Later, on the walk home.
Wow, so Dad seemed kind of different today, huh? It was almost like I was just another kid in the class. Except he was nicer to them than he was to me. I mean, not right now, Becky. He's never said that to me. Time to do what I do best. Because no one ever says, not right now, Word Girl. Word!
Boy, you're a real pro at that. You sure you never done this before?
Actually, I do this 3 times a week, at least.
Come on! come on! We gotta hurry before work, girl!
Stop right there, Butcher! And Kid Potato, how are you, sir?
Nice to see you.
Oh, man, I knew it!
Really? The big bad butcher is scared of a little girl and a pet koala?
But Pop!
Damn, but Pop me. You don't see any of these other nice people getting all worked up over Miss Red Pajamas over there?
Hey!
That's because they're not the ones committing a crime!
Always with the excuses.
Huggy is a monkey and these aren't pajamas!
Okay.
And you should try to be a little nicer to your son.
But he keeps doing everything wrong.
Oh, come on. He's not doing everything wrong.
My bad.
You were saying?
Do you expect your son to be perfect all the time?
Yeah, do you expect me to be perfect all the time?
Dab, actually, the word is expect. It means to anticipate, watch for, or look for something. If your father, Kid Potato, expected there could be a mistake, he could prepare for it instead of blaming you.
Oh.
And how does he expect you to do a good job if he's picking on you?
Yeah!
And he should not expect you to be completely quiet when you're doing knee bends.
Yeah!
Huh?
I mean, someone asks you a question, you answer it, right? Even if it is during gym class.
For some reason, I don't think we're talking about me anymore.
Oh, sorry. My dad is my new teacher at school.
Whoa.
Whoa.
I know, right? It's just weird. He's nicer to my friends than he is to me. I have to call him Mr. Bot, Mr. his last name. It's just, ugh.
Wow, word girl. Seems like you got a lot of stuff on your mind.
Yeah.
Well, here's some more stuff to go on your mind. Pastrami attack!
Yeah!
Pastrami on your mind. Get it?
Good one.
Hey, you forgot the furry thing. Potato pie pow!
Ha! Should I,
Let's get in the car.
The next day.
You know, I don't like when the butcher robs banks, but I can't believe the way Kid Potato treats his son. Always criticizing him, picking on him in front of the whole class.
Class?
And he didn't even give me a ride to school today. Oh, no, not Kid Potato, my dad. Can you believe we have to walk to school? I know we usually walk, that's not the point. Oh man, not again.
Kid. Quite get the angle.
We get a great space in front of the store we're gonna rob, and you can't park.
I know I can't let them rob the store, but if we stop them, I'll be late for school. Yes, I know what to do.
Great. Now I'm all car sick.
Well, if you just stop complaining and let me park.
You can start complaining when I park you in jail.
Nice one.
Thank you.
So how's the whole teacher-dad thing working out?
No, no. You're not going to distract me again. Yeah, my dad's on the faculty at school, so what?
Whoa, I never said anything about your dad on a factory.
No, not a factory, a faculty. A faculty is another name for the group of teachers at school.
Oh, just think, if a factory made teachers, it would be a faculty factory, huh?
Hey, kid. What do you call an entire group of potatoes?
I don't know. What do you call it?
A getaway! Butter-Rooties Platoon! You got stopped from doing a crime before you even got in the store. That's got to be some kind of a record.
Just leave it alone, Pop.
Well, Becky Botsford, nice of you to join us. Please take your seat.
Oh.
And remember, everyone, tomorrow is Dads and Donuts Day. We'll greet and eat. All dads are invited to stop by and enjoy a cinnamon bun with me. Becky, please see me after class.
Yes, Mr. Botsford?
You seem a little down today. Is everything okay?
Yeah. I mean, no. I mean, well, I kind of feel like you're picking on me.
What? Becky?
Like you expect me to be perfect, and when I make a mistake, you...
What, I tell you that you're wrong?
Well, yeah.
Now, Pumpkin, I don't think I should go easy on you just because you're my daughter.
I don't want you to. Too much. Maybe just a little.
But, Becky, the reason I'm so hard on you is because I know you're good enough and smart enough to handle it. Maybe I need to remind you of that more often.
Thanks, Dad.
I want you to know that I'm sometimes your teacher, but I'm always your dad. Now, what do you say we seal this deal with an official Botsford hug?
Give me the wheel! Give me the wheel!
Robbery at the jewelry store? Dad, Bob and I are really enjoying our walks home, so we're going to leave now and let you get back to work.
Okay. Oh, and Becky, don't tell anyone, but you're my number one favorite mathematician.
Aw, thanks, Mr. Dadford.
Come on, hurry up and park. There's still time left on that meter.
Correction, your time's up.
Meh.
Yeah, not my best.
What, Sonny?
Uh-oh.
You know, Butcher, I learned something today. I learned that, yes, sometimes your dad can be hard on you, and he may expect a lot more from you than he does other people, but that's only because he thinks you're really great.
My son.
Come here, Bob. Come in for the big one. Come here. Nope. Oh. You know, this is great, Pop, but we really gotta remember, get away first, then hug.
You can't fight your emotions, son.
And so, on Dads and Donuts Day, the newest member of the faculty, Mr. Botsford, was both Becky's dad and her teacher. And they knew exactly what to expect from each other so they'd never be confused again. Next time, grab your dad or a donut or both and drive over to join us for another emotional and always pop quizzical episode of Word Girl.
Word Girl!
Hello, I'm Bo Handsome, and this is... As usual, the player who correctly defines today's featured word will win a fabulous prize. Let's play!
May I have a word?
Yes, you may. Today's featured word is imitate. To give you a clue, here are some clips from Word Girl that show the meaning of the word.
I think imitate means to dance and sing, right?
No, it does not. Yes, Emily.
Imitate means to mimic or impersonate. Like in that last clip where Huggy is imitating Tiny Big's moves.
That is correct. Huggy, what are you doing? Okay, well, I'm sure you have your reasons. Anyway, congratulations, Emily. I'd really appreciate it if you'd stop imitating me. Emily, you are today's winner! You know, that's really quite distracting. Huggy, show her what she's won. An official Bo Handsome microphone! Emily, you're really gonna have fun with that.
I am.
Indeed! That's it for today's episode. See you next time on...
May I have a word?
Listen for the words solo and collaborate. It's a hot summer day, and everyone's at the beach, swimming, playing, relaxing, and check this out. Becky and Bob are collaborating on a sandcastle that's looking very professional. Hey, I call them like I see them.
Just needs one last finishing touch. Let's see. Can I get some fanfare?
Huh?
Thank you, Squire Bob. I hereby declare this castle open for business. Or something. And it shall forever fly the flag of Pretty Princess of Sparkletopia. You want our castle to fly a flag for Captain Huggy of Faceburg? But that's not even a real thing. Well, of course Pretty Princess is real. She's on TV. Great, so we'll just stick with Pretty Princess. No, Pretty Princess. Pretty Princess. Pretty Princess. Pretty Princess! Okay, let's just catch our breath here for a minute. Everybody needs to calm down. Pretty Princess. Fine, you know what? Maybe we shouldn't even be collaborating on a castle. Exactly. We'll just start over and each work solo to build our own sandcastles. Then we can each fly whatever flag we want. Huh, I'm better off alone anyway. That drawbridge you made is clearly not wide enough to fit Magic Pony's candy corn chariot. You think my moat is not deep enough to hold alligators? Humph! I'm officially working solo. You stay on your side of the sand, and I'll stay on mine.
Meanwhile, nearby, all the scariest and hungriest villains have come to the beach in order to relax and take a day off from committing crimes. The Villain School Barbecue is in full swing.
And that was the third craziest dream Invisibil ever had.
Oh, how fascinating and interesting and riveting.
Goodbye. Hello. Bye-bye. Hi again. Want to hear the fourth craziest dream? Oh, well. How you doing? So long.
No. Whammer's cooking up some Wham and Wham dogs. Wham, wham, wham. Done.
Wham dog? Is that a hot dog? Do you have anything for vegans? Is there a fruit plate or something?
Hello! Invisibil, that's me! Yay!
Whammer is impressed by Invisibil's go away and come back trick. Now Whammer wants to show you his power! Oh, wham!
Wow! Whammer and Invisibil are so similar!
I know!
Maybe we can collaborate and pull off a great crime together.
One way to find out is Wham!
Yay! Invisibil and Whammer! Bye-bye!
So, oh, man! I mean, oh, man, this is fun. Yep, working solo, doing everything myself, that's the way to go. Who needs a friend to sit there ruining all your good work?
Best friends, yay!
Hey!
Goodbye!
Wham and Friendship happening over here! Yeah!
Hello!
Great. Not that I'm suggesting we collaborate, but if there's a crime about to happen, we should probably go stop it, right? Word up.
Later, at Reginald's jewelry store.
Wham! Wham!
Hello!
Yeah. Whammer would appreciate your attention for just a few moments while the items in the store are being whammed by Whammer's pal. Invisibil, yeah!
That's me! Invisibil! Yay!
Stop right there! Grab those jewels, Captain Huggy Face! Why don't I grab them? Well, no, I never said that. I know we have to capture them. I was planning on doing a monkey throw. What do you mean a person throw?
One, two, three,
what?
Take that word, girl! Yay, Whammer! Yay, Invisibil! We won! Bye! Hi!
Oh, yeah! When friends collaborate, nothing can stop them!
Yay! Collaborate! What does that mean again?
I got this. Collaborate means work together on something. Whammer could never defeat us on his own, neither could you for that matter. But you collaborated and somehow got the best of us. For now.
Yay! Collaborate! Invisibil loves that word! Goodbye! Hello! Where'd I go? I'm right here!
Does he ever give that a rest?
I hope not. You guys are missing out working solo, yeah. Collaborating is easy when you're working with your
best friend in the world, yay! Invisibil and Whammer are such good friends, we're even finishing each other's sandwiches.
Whams, yeah.
What? I mean, yeah! Invisibil had so much fun robbing the jewelry store. Yay, Invisibil!
Out of the Whammer! Wham, Whammer!
Oh, let's do something fun, like, I don't know.
Rob the jewelry store again?
Yeah!
out here, if I was talking to my friend Bob, which I'm not, I'd say how it was weird to see Whammer and Invisible becoming such good friends and collaborating. I hate to admit it, but they were really working well together. Yeah, I also know a couple of superheroes who used to be like that. And for the record, Becky thinks friendship is more important than getting your way, too. I'm sorry, Bob. I shouldn't have insisted on a pretty princess castle, and your drawbridge was really good. I could never stay mad at you. I really am sorry. Oh, no, I mean, it's okay. You don't have to say sorry just because I said sorry, but you are, though, right? Yay!
Another whammin' crime, yo!
Yay, sand!
Wham for me!
I've had enough, Bob. How about you? We're gonna collaborate and catch those guys!
Finally, everything back to its rightful... Who did that? Because I'm going to... Get in here and sit quietly while you take whatever you want. Would anyone like a cup of tea?
Yay! This is gonna be even better than last time! Disappear! Reappear! That's what I do!
More like what you don't do! Rob the jewelry store, that is. Like, cause you said... never mind. Just freeze!
Let's defeat Word Girl again! Yay!
Whammer loves that idea! This is gonna be easy as... okay!
Ha! It wasn't easy at all, was it? Now that we're collaborating... Nice flip, Huggy! I didn't throw you too hard, did I? Okay, just making sure, because...
Hey! Whammer and Whamvisible are trying to commit a whamming crime over here!
Yeah! No, I'm not! Yes, I am!
You know, I think I liked it better when you were each working solo.
Excuse me, I hate to interrupt this stunning display of heroism, but did you just say solo? Is that a word, solo? What is that?
I'm glad you asked. Solo means... Oh, did you want to define it? That's right. Solo means doing something alone or by yourself. Whammer and Invisible used to commit crime solo, but now they're working together.
Oh, yeah!
Collab-o-ray! Ting! Yay! Collaborating! Collab-o-ray-ting!
Yeah, right. Anyway, it doesn't matter because now that Captain Huggy Face and I are collaborating again, there's no chance you'll get away!
I'm getting out of here! Goodbye!
William?
You want this one? Please, I insist.
Hey, no fair!
That's Whammer's best friend, you! Whammer's gotta help! Whammer's got... Hello!
There are two of them, Huggy. I don't know if a monkey throw's gonna work. If only you were the size of a... I got it! A person throw! Whee!
No, not yay. Opposite of yay.
Oh, Whammer!
Great collaboration, Huggy. Go team!
And so, Word Girl and Captain Huggy Face are able to collaborate. And more importantly, they rediscover the power of Whamship. I mean, friendship.
Invisible wants to ride with his best friend, Whammer!
Wham too!
I literally could not care less.
Friendship bracelets!
I gotta admit, they're Wham-dorable.
Oh boy. Will the Whammer and Invisibil's friendship last? Will Becky and Bob ever finish their sandcastle? Will anyone remember to let Reginald out of that display case?
Hello, anyone? I'm still sitting in here solo, getting very cold.
Find out on another exciting, stupendous, whamming episode of Word Girl.
Word Girl!
Hello, I'm Bo. Awesome. And this is the bonus round of...
May I have a word?
Our returning champion will have a chance to play for even greater prizes on the bonus round. Emily, you correctly defined the word imitate. Ready to play the bonus round?
You bet.
Great. Take a look at these three pictures and tell me which one shows the definition for imitate.
shot, Emily.
It's gotta be number two. Word Girl is imitating Toby, and I don't think Toby likes it.
That's correct, which means you're our bonus round winner. Show her what she's won, Huggy. An official Whamship microphone storage box. See you next time on
May I Have a Word?
Is it a porcupine? A muskrat? A kangaroo? No, it's Captain Huggy Face.
Great work, Huggy.
Your favorite monkey sidekick. Watch Word Girl and Huggy on PBSKids.org. Word up! Want more Word Girl? Watch your favorite episodes and test your word power on PBSKids.org. Want Word Girl's word power? Fly over to your local library. Cape not required. Word up!